Ladies and gentlemen, today's program is called The Jazz Connection. For some people, this may sound downright sinister, evoking lurid images of undercover deals in dark alleys and smoky nightclubs. But the connection to which I refer is totally out in the open, and it refers to the wonderful blood relationship that exists between the seemingly separate worlds of Broadway show music and jazz. It is a connection that sums up a good deal of the history of American popular music during the first half of the 20th century and beyond. First, there is the indisputable influence from the very beginning that jazz and other forms of African-American music had on the American popular composers like Irving Berlin, Jerome Kern, and George Gershwin. This influence was so profound that it literally determined what made the songs of these composers sound uniquely American as opposed to something else. But that's only half the story. The other half begins in the 1920s, when the current of influence started moving the other way. This is when we start to see the show tunes of the major Broadway composers being adopted by jazz musicians as vehicles for improvisation. Not all composers, or listeners for that matter, were happy about this development. But jazz players ignored their complaints and kept doing it anyway, and they've never stopped. For decades now, hundreds of songs, clearly written for an entirely different dramatic purpose, songs such as All the Things You Are by Jerome Kern or My Funny Valentine by Richard Rodgers, have enjoyed a double life, simultaneously as jazz standards and as they were originally intended, straight dramatic songs. And let it be said as firmly as possible that this back and forth cross-fertilization process has been nothing but good for the music. It has enriched it and helped to perpetuate it as well. Today, we are going to take a look at this wonderful phenomenon through the work of two famous songwriters who differ markedly from the other writers, most of the other writers that we have considered in this series, in that they came to songwriting from a solid background of jazz performance. Our first subject is Fats Waller, one of the greatest and most influential and even visible of all jazz pianists. Now, the question is, how did this affect the way he wrote songs? Well, let's listen to one.